Hi drummers, hope you're well. Right, nice basic practice along for you today. This is going to be single strokes, double strokes, paradiddles, the holy trinity of drum rudiments. And this is aimed at beginner drummers, grade one, grade two. I've had loads of new channel members coming in recently who are at the beginning of playing the drums. So shout out to all of them, either just starting or, like I said, been doing a little bit for a few weeks, maybe, or grade one, maybe grade two as well. And a lot of people are saying, can we have some more practice along, play along, like warm up rudiment type of videos? Of course, here you go. This is going to be along to Remember by Becky Hill. Here we're going to play, like I say, the Holy Trinity, singles, doubles, paradiddles. We're going to play them as quarter notes or crotchets, first of all. So one, two, three, four. We'll then go on to play them as eighth notes or quavers, one and two and three and four, and which is how they appear in the grade one and grade two Trinity books. Let's recap real quick, just in case you need to know. A single stroke roll is right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, or left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, if you're left-handed. Double stroke roll is right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, or left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, if you're left-handed. And paradiddles are right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, or left, right, left, left, right, left, right, right. We're also going to play along a foot pattern here. We're going to use the foot pattern from Trinity College London Drum Kit Grade 1. I really like doing it with a foot pattern. If you really are just getting started with the basic sticking, and that in itself is challenging enough at first, then cool, do that. But if you've got that going, I would definitely put the foot pattern in here. And the foot pattern goes on quarter notes on crotchets, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So bass drum, hi-hat, bass drum, hi-hat. And it doesn't waver from that all the way. So one, two, three, four. What I really, really like about this is it gets your feet working straight away, and especially that left foot. How many drummers, man, come along, who've been playing a little bit, or perhaps do the maybe the, follow the Trinity rock and pop grades, which I love, by the way, nothing against them, but often if they've only just, all they've done is follow those songs, often their left foot hasn't really got moving, and then they hit a certain level, suddenly they need to do it, like shout out to everyone doing Brown Eyed Girl grade four, Trinity rock and pop, all of a sudden in the chorus, you've got to go. With that left foot working, and if you haven't done it before, I've seen many a drummer just have their mind blown by the idea that a left foot suddenly needs to work. So let's get those feet working right from the start here. So all the way, bass, hi-hat, bass, hi-hat. We'll do firstly quarter notes on the snare drum. We'll go through singles, doubles, paradiddles. I'll shout it all out as we go. We'll then do eighth notes on the snare, singles, doubles, paradiddles. And finally, we'll do eighth notes going around the kit. We'll do four hits on each drum, going around the kit. Again, follow me. What I'll do as well, in a pinned comment, so if you're on YouTube, look at, go to the comment section, the first comment will be a timestamp. Click on that timestamp and the practice along element of this video will begin straight away, and you'll bypass all this waffle. A couple of things we're thinking about as beginners, drummers near the start. One is our grip on the stick, so a nice pinch between the top crease in your finger there and the fleshy part of your thumb, about one third of the way up. I always say to all the kids I teach in particular, when you, you know when you've got this right, because you can do that thing we all did with our pencil or pen at school where it looks like it's going all bendy, then you, a stick will go through the crease here in the back of your hand, wrap your fingers around, not too tight, not too loose, like the old cliche is a little bird in your hand with its wings folded. You wouldn't want to squeeze too tight and hurt it, too loose, it would wriggle out and fly off. And when we throw the stick down, the tip of the stick is going to act like a basketball, bouncing back off the drum or a tennis ball. It's a great George Double in his book. At the start, he talks about throwing down a tennis ball off a concrete floor, have it bounce back to your hand, that kind of feel. Throw it down from the wrist, let the stick bounce back. So like I say, play along portion will start now.
I'm doing just
so
fine,
bass drum
now
and
high.
Three,
I've been moving on and living my life.
One, two, bass, hi-hat, bass, hi-hat. Okay, first one is quarter notes,
and
snare drum, single stroke roll. Here we go.
If I could go back in time,
right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Okay, still quarter notes, double. Here we go. Right, right, left, left, right, right. Okay, still quarter notes. Paradiddles, here we go. Right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left.
Right, left, left.
back to single strokes, eight notes. Here we go. Okay, double strokes, eight notes. Now, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left. Paradiddles now. Right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. Okay, eight notes, singles round the kit. Now. Okay, same. Double strokes now. Right, left, left, right, right. And same thing, paradiddles now. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left. Just like that. It's a perfect little warm-up. If you're starting off, grade one, grade two, like I say, if you're just getting your hands working, just leave your feet out at first, that's fine. By the way, you could totally be here, and I've noticed that quite a lot of channel members have said this, that they'd signed up. They actually don't even own a drum kit at this point. So people always say, oh, do I need a drum kit to learn the drums? Well, yeah, mate, you do, obviously. But sooner or later, you do. But the first bit, absolutely fine if you've got a practice pad just to get started, or a tabletop, or the arm of a chair, or a pillow, or a cushion, or a textbook, or a folder, or on your shoe. Or even if you're watching this video, right, and you don't even have sticks handy, just do it with your flipping hands on the table. People think of so many good reasons why they can't do something. Oh, I haven't got a drum kit. I haven't got this. Just hands on your knees. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Double strokes. Paradiddles. That'll get you started, man. Just get the blood flowing. Get moving. You need to be doing something every day. If you've got this, if you've taken this thing on, if you've made a great life-changing decision to be a musician, to be a drummer, you need your brain and your hands and your feet doing it every day. So even if you're just on a practice pad, or if you're just on a tabletop, even if you're not holding drumsticks, just play along with this. Obviously, on the bit where it goes around the kit, don't do that. Just stay on whatever surface you're on. And then as you get comfortable with this, add the feet in, of course. So this is as it's written, like I say, in grade one for Trinity College drum kit. There they've got it written as eighth notes with the sticks and quarter notes with your feet. One and two and three and four. And you might well find that tricky at first if you're starting off. Obviously, at that point, you wouldn't necessarily play along with this video immediately. You need to do a little bit of building it up. So, for example, say that you were doing the double strokes as eighth notes, working out the foot pattern. You've got right, right, left, left. And the best way to do it, honestly, it's just tried and tested like way of doing it over the generations, is you say each event out loud and then you do it. So in that case, you'd go right stick and bass drum, right stick on its own, left stick and hi-hat, left stick on its own, and so on. And this is the bit that so many people just try and miss out. And this is why things are hard or things are complicated if you try and play too soon without having done a bit of that. You've got to set the precedent in your nervous system. According to my perspective on this, in my opinion, you've just got to show your hands and your feet and your brain what's happening a little bit before you build up speed too much. But assuming that you've got to that point and you've got them all flowing, brilliant. What I'll do on the channel members page, as always, in fact, I'm going to handwrite this out today. I'll write out this whole exercise so you can do exactly that if you need to. You can see it all there, and you can, if you need to do a bit of programming in just on some of the combinations, if you need to sort of go slow at first and just work it up, you can do exactly that. I'll write it all out by hand, like I say, post that on the channel members page shortly. Thanks for watching, as always, really appreciate it. Like I say, check out the pinned comment if you're on YouTube below, because that will be a timestamp. If you click on that, it will go straight to the beginning of the play along element. You won't need to listen to all my waffle twice, why would you? And then this recreates really exactly what we do in the sessions that I teach, where we have the two drum kits, you know, side by side, stick the music on in the PA, have a little play along, and after 3 or 4 minutes, hopefully we're warmed up and ready to go. But also just repetition of this will just again, build all those lovely core fundamentals that drummers, in my experience, quite often overlook. So the basic strike on the drum, basic coordination, movement around the kit. And drummers who haven't done this in the early stages, so often, just again in my experience, and no disrespect to anybody, but they're quite often the drummers who later down the line say, oh, I can't move around, I seem to have a problem flowing around the kit. They seem surprised when they start to try and play things more quickly and the physical side of their playing, the hands and feet won't sort of keep up. Get drilling on stuff like this as soon as you get started on the drums and you're in business, man. I'm always saying it, but it's just an idea really close to my heart. Your head, heart and hands, three things when you learn a musical instrument. Head, music theory, understanding, learning songs, that's an important part. Heart, groove, feel, creativity, that's massive. That's the whole reason we, most of us, in my case anyway, why we wanted to become musicians in the first place. But you can't overlook hands, physical skills. You've got to build physical skills. Like sports people, they don't just go onto the pitch and play a game of rugby or a game of football and expect to play well. They train, they go to the gym, they train, they drill so that the physical side of their performance is ready. They can trust their bodies to do the things that they need to do. That's exactly what we're doing here by playing it along to music. Hopefully we'll make it as fun as possible. So I hope that was useful. Shout out to all the new channel members who are at the near the beginning of their drumming. Thanks so much for putting your faith in this channel, and hopefully this video is helpful. I'll do loads more like this. And thanks so much for watching. As always, really appreciate it. If you've found these videos useful or helpful, please consider either buying me a coffee via my Buy Me a Coffee support page. Thanks a million to all the lovely people who do that. Or becoming a channel member. As a channel member for £10 a month, you're supporting this channel, becoming part of it, helping it grow. And of course, I'd hugely appreciate it. You also get the notation and the practice alongs for tutorial videos like this. Like I said, I'm going to write out this full thing, the whole sheet. I'll do it by hand today. Notation and post that on the channel members page. You also get a complimentary Zoom session or face-to-face session with me, so we can put our heads together and formulate it for you. If you want a practice plan, a head, heart and hands practice plan, which you can then work on, and I'll update for you as you progress with your drumming. You also get access to, if you want them, future sessions from there to check in, and then ongoing drum support. You can send me your questions anytime. I'll do my best to answer them. You can send me your practice videos and audio. I'll have a watch and a listen. I love sitting at my kitchen table and watching everybody's videos, and hopefully I'd normally do video responses as feedback, hopefully giving some objective feedback. Absolutely love doing that. Thanks a million to all the channel members who've come in and made this something really amazing in my life as well. Hopefully it's been useful for you guys. If that sounds like it'd be of interest to you, details either above or below, depending on where you're watching this, it'll say buy a coffee/become a channel member. Click on the link there, or just Google Mike Barnes Drums, Buy Me a Coffee, and the page will come up. Thanks a million for watching us. Always really appreciate it. Any questions about that or anything else, give us a shout. See you soon.